And I'm inviting you this morning, Jesus is inviting you. You either will come or you'll make an excuse. Some's excuse is, Lord, I'll come, but not right now. Maybe you love the Lord and you're His, but you've neglected that table, that place of fellowship. Maybe you used to be closer to Him than you recognize at the moment you're not where you used to be with Him. Come on, He still loves you. He ain't mad at you. He'll never turn anybody away that'll come to Him, John 6:37. You may just be sitting there standing this morning saying, I'm drawing nigh to Him, but I just want to get closer. And if you're under the sound of our voice, whether you're in here or you're watching and you're just saying, I know I need to come to His table. I need to come to that fellowship because I am away from God and I'm going to miss heaven if I don't come to Him. Friend, come right now. Come just like you are, and I promise you, you'll leave like Him. You'll leave like Him. You'll leave in Him today in the name of Jesus. You won't leave Him, but you'll leave in Him. You understand that? Hallelujah. Bring it all to the table. There is nothing He ain't seen before. Through all your sins, all your sorrow and your sadness, there's a Savior and He calls. Bring it all to the table. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, thank you for what you're doing today. God, we speak your blood. Brother Marvin, what did I say to a God? What did I say to the God, the Lord Jesus? Just come to Him. If you don't know what to say, say Jesus. Because whoever calls on the name of the Lord, they'll be delivered, Joel 2:32. Whoever calls on the name of the Lord, they'll be saved, Romans 10:13. Just call on Him. Say, Jesus, I'm calling on you. Jesus, I'm asking you, Lord, to forgive me too. Jesus, save me. Jesus, deliver me, Jesus. I'm coming back to you. Come on, bring it on. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Matthew 11:28. Hallelujah. He did not do no more something in the best out of behind. I don't know what this means, but God shows me an image of you like somebody that's fallen down for a moment. But God says today when you walk out of my house, there'll be no dust from the past on you. Hallelujah, because God says today, I'm rekindling and doing something new and fresh in you. Because I got a plan for you in my kingdom. Oh yeah, I have my divine oil I've placed on you and I've chosen you. God, even you said a just man may fall 7 times and he rises again, Proverbs 24:16. And I declare there's a rising up this time, oh, further than ever before. God, and I give you praise. Anything that's been on him is being dusted off now in your presence. Hallelujah. Oh yeah, Lord, I don't know what that's all about. Even the pressures from his past and the things from the old life and the stuff that's just been vexing him on every side. God, I thank you that he's victor over today. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:7. Holy Ghost, touch this house, touch this family. In the name of Jesus, I speak the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Ooh. God said, I don't hold anything against you when you call on my name. God says it's like it was never even done when you call on my name. Whoa. God says our sins and iniquities he would remember no more. Hebrews 10:17. Lord, I thank you. You don't hold them against us. And God, I thank you today. Hallelujah. Nothing is held against those that call on the name of Jesus today. I give you praise, God, for freedom in these altars. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Bring it all to the altar. Call it. the altar right now. Thank you, Jesus. God, I speak your blood over this child. She's yours. In the name of Jesus, behold, I'm set before a table that I've prepared. Ooh. In the presence of your enemies, I know you have with all, and your cup will run over. Psalms 23:5. Oh, it appears like the cup's been dry for a while, daughter. But you stay at the table. Even though the enemy's presence is all around you, stay at my table. Don't get up from that table. Don't let the enemy make you get up from this table. Because if you stay at this table, I'll give you your mind back at this table. I'll give you your life back at this table. I'll give you the joy back at this table. I'll give you victory back at this table. And your cup will overrun at this table. Everybody look at somebody. Tell them, say, whatever you do, don't let the presence of the enemy make you get up from the table. Where's the table? It's where God put you. It's where God placed you. Bring it all to the table in the name of Jesus. Lord, I speak your blood. Speak your blood, Lord. Hallelujah. God, I declare the blood of the Lamb over his kids. Bring it all to the table. Somebody say, stay at the table. Been a lot of pressures. The enemy coming at you from every side. But God said, stay at the table. Even in the presence of the enemy. Because I'm sitting here with you. Woo. And I am the meal. Taste the Lord. See that he is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. Psalms 34:8. In the name of Jesus. Holy, holy. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Oh, that's him. That's fire. Here he comes. Fire. Fire, Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of the Lord. Holy, 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 holy. He removes your shoulder from the burden. Psalms 81:6. Hallelujah. Lord told me to tell you, you don't have to figure everything out about me, says the Lord. Just have faith in me. Mark 11:22 says, have faith in God. And I'll prove to you, you do have faith in God. Because sometimes you feel like you don't. The presence of doubt proves that you do believe. Because when doubt starts coming to you and making you doubt what you've heard God said and what you've experienced, even in this altar, this house, God said the presence of that doubt and unbelief is proof you have believed. Because why would doubt try to attack anything but faith? Because the fight's against your faith. 1 Corinthians 6:16 says, fight the good fight of faith and lay hold on eternal life. Somebody say, if something's fighting my faith in God, that's proof that my faith in God is a reality. It is real. Jesus loves you. I know you know that. And get this, he loves you just like you are. But he'll love you so much if you let him, you won't stay like you are. And everything you can't figure out, that's okay. He even knows when you don't know. He knows what you have need of for you. Ask him, Matthew 6:8. Psalms 139:1 said, he searches you and knows you. He knows you better than you do yourself. And God says, you're mine. I'm saying it today by the Spirit of the Lord. You belong to him. And wherever you're trying to find help from and find where you fit in, I'll tell you where you fit in and where you'll find everything you were born and put on this earth to be and do. You'll find it in Jesus. Amen. I promise you that. I was 18. How old are you? 14. I was 18 when I gave my life to Jesus. I wish I'd have been even younger. That's the only regrets I have. I wish I'd have did it sooner. Hallelujah. Praise God. But I'm telling you, I'm not telling you a lie. I'm not telling you everything's easy when you follow God. But your life is in His hands. God's telling me, He said, I've already protected and preserved you from so much already. Hallelujah. And following God ain't about keeping you from enjoying life. He's got your future all laid out. He's got who you gonna marry, your kids in the future as an adult. He's got all your life in Him. The Bible said in Colossians 2 and 10, in Him you're complete. You won't find it nowhere else. Believe me, I've been there. I've looked for it in a bottle. I've looked for it in these relationships, these friendships, and all around. And I'm not speaking anything negative personally towards you or trying to make a statement. I'm just telling you from my own personal experience. At 18, suicidal. I didn't want to live. I had a shotgun laying on the bed. I was about to take my life. And a little red Gideon Bible they gave me when I was in the fifth grade, and I'm 18 now. Done at the graduating age. Sadly, I'd quitiated, but I did go back. But I opened that little Bible, and I read Revelation 1:1. It says the revelation of Jesus Christ. I can't explain it, though I experienced it. It's like somebody touched the back of my head, and there were nobody there. I had never cried like I cried. And the reason you're crying right now is because it ain't me talking. That's Him talking. He's doing this. He's loving on you. And He's just trying to let you know it's Him. Whatever you're missing, whatever you're trying to look for, in Him's where it's all going to make sense at, where it's going to be worth the living at. But anyhow, I felt that touch, and I read that Revelation 1:1. It said the revelation of Jesus Christ. And for the first time in my life, I said, Lord, all these times growing up young in church, it was just a service, a song, a sermon, or a class, or an activity with the youth or whatever. For the first time in my life, I realized He is real. He is a really alive person, not just some religious God figure, you know, a memory or something that somebody's trying to use to take away the fun that I'm having in my life right now. He was real, and I experienced Him, and I've never been the same since, and I'm still being changed. But I was suicidal that night. When I got up off my knees, I weren't suicidal anymore. I didn't have to have an alternate drug to counteract my so-called depression or whatever was going on. In that moment, God said, and I was so sick in my body, doctors didn't even know what to do for me. I had all kind of stuff going on in my body. But I'm just telling you that, relaying that to you, let you know Jesus loves you, He knows you, He's got you. And Lord, I declare Psalms 4:3, you separate the godly for yourself. She belongs to you. And Lord, I declare she will follow you, she will serve you. And Lord, every puzzle that she's trying to navigate through right now, this maze, I thank you, Jesus, you're going to put an A in front of her maze, because it's been like a maze. She's been, Lord, just like she's bouncing off back and forth, not knowing, trying to discover, find who, what. God, I thank you that an A is going to come in front of it. And Jesus, it's going to be amazing. It won't be a maze no more, to be amazed. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, I claim her as yours. She belongs to Jesus. Yes, Lord. And I thank you, God, everything the enemy's even attempted and tried, it is over with. It will not work from this point forward. In Jesus' name. Haley. When I say it, hear Him say it. Yeah, He knows you by name. The Bible tells us that. He knows you by name. He calls you by name. So you're important to Him. He knows everything about you. And the only way you can see a fulfillment of what He's got planned for you is follow Him. And you don't have to be perfect at it. We learn from our mistakes. Just keep following Him, even though you can't figure it all out. It's just always by faith. You always know He's there. He's there and He does care. And He's got you. Yeah, yeah, He's got you. Somebody say, He's got me. He's got me. God ain't trying to figure me out. He searches me. He knows me. He knows you, Brother Brad. Lift your hands. So sometimes you feel like you want a merry-go-round. You feel like you go right back through and through and then. And I'm fitting to say something to you. I saw you at a table not long ago, and God says you've been dealing with a heavy depression for a while. But the Lord's about to set you free from that. Sometimes you lay awake at night in bed, and you're trying to figure it all out in your head. And sometimes you just don't even want to get up and try again. Hallelujah. But the Lord sets you free today, because God says to you just like he does to her. You feel him, don't you? That's him. Colossians 2:10. Whew, I feel the Holy Ghost in me. You're complete in Jesus' name. God says you can trust in me who hang on the cross. That you wear around your neck, I literally hung on it for you. Hallelujah. And Brandon, I got you in my hand also, son. Your life, your future. The only way you'll find it is go after me with all your heart. Hallelujah. And Lord, I thank you that spirit of heaviness comes off of him. He is not a piece of trash. He is a treasure from God. I bind that stuff off of him today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. God says sometimes it comes easy for you to make other people laugh, but God said a lot of times what people don't see is you're hurting so deep inside you're doing it to try to make yourself laugh. But God said there's an hour coming you're going to make people laugh. It ain't going to be because you're trying to make yourself laugh. It's going to come out of joy. Whew, in the name of Jesus. Somebody ought to give God praise, because that's the Holy Ghost talking. Yeah, I'm glad I come to his table. Thank you, Lord. Touch Sister Melissa today, Lord. Hallelujah. Holy, holy, he'll fix it at the table. Daughter, you're never alone. Even when you sit by yourself in your home, seen your tears, I've heard your cries, I've heard you asking why, but I'm there, even in your home, you're not alone. Even when you sleep at night, I'm standing there, you're not by yourself. God, hallelujah. Lord would say, even when you're up at night and you can't sleep, I'm there. Hallelujah. Bring it all to the table. The chance is free. The Lord says, I've seen how hard it's been. Did all you can do even to get back to my house, but now that you're here, I'm rescuing you, I'm helping you. Holy, bring it all to the table. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Somebody say, oh, taste the Lord, see that he is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. Psalms 34. Look at somebody and tell them, say, we've been here right at 2.5 hours. What happens when you go to a good restaurant? You didn't hurt any. Somebody said, eating's been good. Hallelujah. And if you've endured or enjoyed, you benefit either way, because endurance is what it's going to take to make it even to heaven. He that endures to the end, the same will be saved. Matthew 24:13. You know, I wonder about people can't even endure a church service, whether they're going to be able to endure in these end times, even make it when Jesus comes back. But it's so good to see everybody that came this morning, and these altars are still up. Even after you see somebody walk off of this pulpit, you know, don't think you got to walk out the door somehow the service is over. No, this is the Lord's house. These altars is open all the time.